see here our own test board setup that is plugged into the Synopsys HAPS prototyping system with our M-PHY 5.0 test chip here. The HAPS allows us to access the RMMI interface to send and receive data through the two lanes of our test chip. M-PHY is a bidirectional PHY, so we have one TX and RX differential pair per lane. Our PHY here has two lanes, which is a standard configuration for UFS. In our first setup, we are going to look at the transmitter performance of our PHY. We program our M-PHY through the RMMI interface to send high-speed burst signals at a high speed of about 24 gigabit per second. Now we have connected the first lane transmitter to our oscilloscope, where we aggregate our signal. After a short time, the eye analysis presents itself. We can see a clear eye opening, which shows a very robust transmitter performance. And when we look at the scope measurements, we see 28.5 picosecond eye opening, which translates back to our 24 gigabit per second signal. In our last setup, we are going to measure the receiver performance of our silicon. Therefore, we use the loopback setup to measure the bit error rate. The bit error tester device here will send M-PHY signals to our test chip receiver channel. And the test chip will loop back the detected signal back to the tester. The M-PHY CTS describes how to measure this. Basically, a huge number of incrementally more impaired signals are sent to our receiver and then loop back to the tester. The tester records when an error occurs in detecting the signal and plots this on a bit error chart. We can see how the JTOL plot is being generated here in live view. The x-axis shows the jitter and the y-axis shows the amplitude of the jitter. The M-PHY spec requires a bit error rate to be above the dotted line shown here. The green line shows the highest error amplitude of a certain jitter frequency where no errors were detected. Here the highest amplitude is actually limited by the physical capabilities of the tester. That being said, we can see a significant margin between the spec required bit error rate shown in the dotted line and the measured green line, which shows us a robust receiver performance. Let me conclude today's demonstration. We've seen clear TX performance at the maximum speed of 24 gigabit per second. We've seen flawless RX functionality behaviors, as well as a powerful receiver capability with significant margin over the MIPI M-PHY 5.0 spec. Thank you for watching.